In this screencast, I'm going to describe how we determine activation energies using polymath, nonlinear regression. Other screencasts describe the problem. Here I'm showing the data and the form. So we're fitting in polymath the rate constant to this form. It makes it easier to do the simulation and know what the initial values are. So what I want to do is first show you the results of polymath, and then we'll look at the polymath program and see how we actually carry out this nonlinear regression. So here are the snapshots from the polymath program that show the K0 value and the activation energy, confidence limits, R-squared value, and then the table from polymath where we input the temperature and the rate constant to the first two columns. Polymath then calculates the best fit, so that's K calculated, and the residual is the difference between the K experimental and the K calculated. And we can see the residuals are relatively small compared to the value, the magnitude of K. And then we'll also look at the plots that polymath will generate. So on the left, the plot of residuals, the difference between the experimental and the calculated rate constant as a function of the rate constant, does not seem to be any pattern, seems random. And the figure on the right shows a plot of the experimental values and the calculated values. You can see they're pretty close to each other. So let's go and look at the polymath program and see how we generate these results.
So here's the polymath program. What I've already done is I've gone in the program, selected nonlinear regression, and then I've entered in by cutting and pasting the data. So the left column is temperature, which means I need to relabel this first column with temperature. And the second column is the rate constant, so likewise I have to label that. Now to carry out nonlinear regression, I over on the right select nonlinear, and what I'm going to do is, just in the interest of time, I'm going to cut and paste in the equation. So I've cut in the equation that we discussed, and it has two parameters, K0 and E, and so polymath immediately brings them up and it asks for initial guesses. Well, as we mentioned, we know at 770 Kelvin, where K0 is evaluated, the value is around 0.2. So let me use that as my initial guess. And for E, I'm going to use 100,000. And this, of course, is because I already have an idea of where the answer is going to be. It is important that our guess be in the right range in order for us to iterate to a solution. Now I'm ready to solve, but it's going to give us a report, but let me select the graph and the residuals, and I'm also going to store the results of the calculation, and it's going to put that in the third column. So when I select the purple arrow, it's going to carry out the solution, and let's look at what it's showing us. It gives us the value of confidence limits for both K0 and E. It gave us the data points, but I've had those entered into the data file I'll show you. Here is the residuals, and there does not seem to be any pattern, which is a good sign, as we mentioned. Fit to the data, the graph that polymath creates. And then in the third column, and I'll rename this as K calculated, because that's the fit. So I'm going to enter the residuals in this fourth column. Going to be equal to the experimental value of K minus the value we calculated from the regression. And so, and I should rename this so that it's clear, this is residuals. And so we can get an idea of how good the fit is. We could certainly transfer this data and plot it to make a better plot in, for example, Excel. But you can see how quickly we can use polymath to carry out nonlinear regression and get values of parameters.